Yo, actually it's called the app Reliable Sewage. To be here, I know every day to waste your time. So if you don't have anything to do, you're in the right place, man. So just sit down and lose your time with me right now. This show is always like, man, it always runs at 8 on the dot. Man, sometime back someone was telling me that they used to wait for me. We used to run at 9:30 there. Then sometimes we would start later. But now it's on the dot. Follow me on my social media. That is Tumusime on Facebook, on Twitter at Tumusime UG, on Instagram at Tumusime UG, then YouTube. Man, I used to say that you don't have OTT, which, but man, I'm shocked, man. I'm dying of flu, man. I think I must have, you know, we queens. What am zendwa diseases, man. This is the queen's body, not immunized, man. So there was a kamuka that once smeared me with this whatever thingy. This, by the way, there's a weird strain of flu going around. Man, in case you get flu in one and cough one of these days, please go and take medicine. You might even, if you have like a witch doctor, even just make a shortcut. Because, man, it's just serious. It gets you and it just weakens you totally. It's going around. I don't even know why the government is not saying anything about it. And we comedians are the ones who are looking out for the public, man. Let's take it, man. So there is this picture that has been making viral. It has been viral. Apparently, you remember in 2014, there was a big headline that Uganda to make cars by 2018. This one, which has just ended, man. Yeah? Uganda, in 2014, was supposed to have been making cars by now. We are progressing. We are making potholes. At least potholes are related to cars because they are in the road. But man, seriously, man, after 4 years of promise, the only thing that we have been able to create is nyege and what, man? Man, let me tell you something. Well, Uganda, now you have a lot of, you believe a lot of these things you see, man. How can someone tell you that in 4 years you're going to make cars? It's like if someone tells you that Uganda by 2018, no, by 2021, we have gone to the moon. Man, which moon, man? This one we see in the sky. You know Katwe? There's a time I talked about that thing on my show sometime back. Go to Katwe and see that. I have always felt that if this government really was serious about technology, something by now should have come out of Katwe. Because Abagai make Katwe, I don't know how true it is. Abagai make Katwe, that's why every time you see like these expensive cars like Range Rover, don't ever be intimidated. When you say Range Rover, nengo mia yateka mu engineer vits. Ojituale Katwe. So you just buy a Range Rover and you know you cannot afford its fuel. You just go there Katwe. Omia yateka mu engineer achi ya border. So usanga Range Rover, onia vuga Range Rover. Usanga Range Rover, omia yajivuga na jijia mukono, yajita one Kampala. And that is one of the things that hurts me. Every time you go in a Ugandan supermarket, everything is made in Kenya and made in India. Like a Biafe, man, you can never find Ugandan products. The only Ugandan products you can find, Umanyi. Osanga yobano. The only things that are made in Uganda, all these things I already see, banabakazi abatunda etaka. Maybe that's what is made in Uganda. Also, there are these plastic cups made in Uganda. Can you believe someone is... That is one of the biggest things we are proud of. Uganda makes cups. Nice. And they also put made in Uganda. Those, about plastic, don't put that thing of made in Uganda. Man. Some people are exporting cups which look like, I don't know, like a vase. And what you call made in something. Negative when producing, you know, this funny stuff. And then take a yafe. At least, what is again? But the thing is, I think that this goes back to our educational system. Our educational system is not vocational based. Education system here from Uganda, yakusire yinga. Have you seen some of these schools? Schools look like apartments, man. These are the schools that you pass by, man. You find schools from day one, the schools look so expensive. The people concentrate on the smartness of the uniform. You find the kids these days, it's like a superficial. The education is superficial. Chuvala umana soma na graduating. Na ye spice dana tamani the difference between 250 and 200 for OTT. Actually, a person graduated and she actually thought she had gotten 32 points. That's how bad it is. Like people are, education is like ceremonial. And whenever education is like ceremonial, it's like everyone is just having it to say like, kari katuga kati education ninga bora bakatuga menga coupon no gamba nasoma nasoma but are really people trained? Do they know what they can do? Marisegera, if we were to have like some real based vocational training, eh, kati everyone now is just like a blogger. But those are the jobs that are there. Influencer, blogger, king of the MC, yeah, MC Cuts, who is the father of DJ Shiru, by the way. Segera. Like, those are the jobs. And you can notice that right now there is this disconnect between what actually creates employment and what people want to study. You know, it's like a soggerific sort of education. And now we had said there was a headline which was saying that the government wants to put regulations on private schools. I really hope that the regulations on private schools will be about really containing that whole luxury that inflates the price, whereby kids go to school and then they say that they are paying 2 million. Why? Because for lunch they eat boiled plantain. Agugaba matoke. Don't think that that's special. Instead of saying matoke, they call it boiled plantain. Then when you ask them what is that, they say matoke boiled with extra garlic. Shitege. Then agama ngoje mitwali sato. Kati mwana agenda sasa mitwala shitege na mwana. No sanga ko binegia chaplain. Chaplain ngafune mitwala chaplain buli mwana sasa mitwali sato ya chaplain. Who isn't to chaplain? Abana luko. If it's 1000 kids, that's what? That's over, that's what? That's 30 million? For a chaplain? What does he pray for, man? Even Mbonye, who goes to Jesus directly, whatever. Why Mbonye, when you pray to Mbonye, he doesn't sit down and he says, God, I submit the prayers. No, he says, write your prayer requests. So the remnants write them on a paper. Then he puts them in a bag and he takes the elevator and he goes to heaven. And then he gives them to Jesus. But even that one wouldn't pay him all that money, 30 million. Man. So this is the whole problem that is happening. And you know, you wouldn't be surprised that some of the things, by now, some of the things we should be doing them in Uganda. By now, right now in Uganda, we shouldn't really be having like a lot of toothpaste from abroad. I'm sorry to say that. Kenya is exporting, is bringing lotions, is bringing like no more Vaseline, no more perfume. In Uganda, you're only known for bleaching creams, man. I don't know what who's cursing us, man. But at the end of the day, it really hurts. It really hurts to see that someone these days can go from nursery. Because you know these days, like nursery is like what, takes 2 years, 3 years sometimes, up to university. And the person is empty, like empty-headed. Like they don't even, they think when you say account, they don't even know a bank account. They know only the Instagram account, man. Anyway, there's some other research that came out. Now, this research was showing the laziest African countries. And Ugandans, you survived. Which is like a miracle, man. I was shocked, man. Apparently, there was Tanzania. But Tanzania, they are so lazy, which is really known, like, man. I don't know. The only person in Tanzania who's not lazy maybe is Diamond. That's it. The other people, yeah. So, then what shocked me is that on that list, there was South Sudan. What? That's like weird, man. Those guys, how can a Dinka man be lazy? Like, does that really make sense to you, man? A Dinka man, those guys, they look strong, they look tall, they speak with force, but research shows that they wake up at 10 and sleep at 7. Man, nozuka sawa nya, kumacha, noeva kasawa sawa meze, just even, and half of that time they're awake, but it could be, you know, mama alwa, you know, these things where they drink from that much. So, South Sudan, congratulations, we are so happy for you. We understand why South Sudan is struggling, man. But I don't know who did this research. I really don't think that South Sudan guys are lazy. Me, I think those guys have too much money to work like us, man. My God, man. Come with those Sudanese pounds and they change them. I have like 20 million and they drink it and all of it, man. But Uganda, we are not there, which is really a shocker because the Wesley Queens have time to be on social media. I up to now don't understand how women and girls on Facebook and Instagram can have pictures, studio pictures, to upload every minute, almost every minute of every, like every hour throughout the day. Nothing which find any gari one sky. Nothing which find any gari one nari governor. Nothing which find no gambo no mana. Where does she get time to take all these pictures? Then after that she tells you goals. God is answering my prayers. Which prayers, man? Just going in the studio, man. We have a very twisted generation. People actually think that progressing in life is getting a picture that doesn't show your pimples. That's it. That's how we think, man. So, I was shocked that Uganda were not there. Because someone, the research said that countries where people, actually Nigeria was number one on the most hardworking list. which is understandable. But Nigeria bakora. Nigerians really push Chitegera. They not only push their content, they even push their broken English. You just find a Ugandan who knows good English, speaking broken English, just to sound Nigerian. Do you know how someone, how important someone is to make you feel like speaking bad English is swaggerific? That is a really influential person, man. Chitegera. That's like someone influencing you that if he bangs your wife, you upgrade your status and you also allow and he bangs her. That's the same thing, really. These guys, they're aggressive. Neka tufabana Uganda, tuliwano, tulina bebe kuru. Yeah, tulina bebe kuru, bebe CJ, Bobby Wine, they are in this reality show. Me, this is what actually I'm suggesting. I think we need to have Big Brother Uganda. And this Big Brother Uganda, in the house we put Bobby CJ, we put Bobby Wine, we put Bebe Kuru, we put which other person is interesting. We got Nandala Mafabi. Mafabi is a creep. He will always be trying to shower from the bathroom of the women. We can put someone else, but Brian White, watch together. Let me tell you, that will be the most watched show in Uganda. Because it has become comedy. We put in Katoru Wama so that he slaps a few people there. Yeah, that show is called Yap, Reliable Nonsense. We are always here on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. At 8 sharp. Up to 8:10, man. In the Chikakomi, watch together. To waste your time and to, you know, just, I don't know, so that you lose some brain cells, man. Watch together. Until tomorrow, have a good night.